Here on site, we cut and bend reinforcement, we fabricate and process fatigue-rated couplers in order to help the wider delivery of HS2. This venture is very rarely undertaken due to, I think, there's a stigma around gaining CARES approval. Construction sites often believe that they're not going to be working there long enough in order to spend the time and the effort on it. But actually, it's saved a vast amount of money by undertaking this process, and it's created massive efficiencies that we will see for the next 3 years within this project. In this area, we have the guillotine where we cut the bars to the correct dimension. This basically then rolls onto the treading operation. And the first step in here is basically the saw, the cold saw that cuts the end of the bar off. This creates a square edge in order to start the process. It's quite important to make sure we have a square edge on it, otherwise it would fail the proof loading. Step two in the process is the cold forging machine, which it freezes and expands the head in order to move it on to the next phase. And the third machine is the chamfer tread roll machine. At this point, the expanded head is fed into the machine. It chamfers the end of the bar, treads it, rolls it, and gets it ready to move on to the last phase, proof loading machine. At this point, it's tested up to the required strength. Once it passes, the end of the bar is stamped with an ABP, completing the 100% QA. So effectively, this is the end product. We have our coupler basically on there, fatigue-rated coupler on the end of the bar. This runs through a process known as cold forging. At that point then, we basically begin to process it into a fatigue-rated connection. Where we're standing here at the moment is the rebar storage yards. We have between 400 and 500 tonne in here at any one time. The quantities of reinforcement of mechanical couplings fatigue rated that we need to create are circa 92,000 couplers, which equates to basically 8 hours a day, 6 days a week working with a team of 14 to 15 inside the yard between the guillotine, cutting and bending and processing of the rebar. We've created 20 new jobs that wouldn't have existed, created training opportunities for engineers. We've shown other sites that it is possible to gain CARES certification, which has only ever been done once before in the UK on the Ford Bridge. As finally, as a result of it, we've actually managed over the life of this venture, we'll probably have taken the bones of 1,000 trucks off the road. Upon receiving this CARES certification, we put ourselves in a position to support the delivery of Copthall Tunnel and to support the wider high-speed twos delivery over the coming years. This on-site solution can offer benefits to the wider high-speed two and the construction industry as a whole.